जय यमुना तीरवन चारी जय कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा हरे रामा राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा हरे रामा राम रामा हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा हरे रामा राम रामा हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम रामा हरे हरे राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ श्री राधे जय जगन्नाथा जय जगन्नाथा जय बालदेवा जय सुभद्रमा जय गौरानीता जय गौरानीता जय गौरानीता जय गौरानीता जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय जय प्रभुपाद जय जय गुरुदेव 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 जय जय गुरुदेव जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परविजयकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतश्री अभयचरणारविंद हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रीला प्रभुपाद की जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परविजयकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतश्री श्रीमद् भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज प्रभुपाद की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की श्री श्री राधा गोपीनाथ भगवान की श्री श्री गौर निताय की जय ताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं उदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेष्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंद गोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः हरे कृष्णा थैंक यू एंड वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस मॉर्निंग श्रीमद् भागवतम क्लास सो फॉर द प्लेजर ऑफ श्री श्री राधा गोपीनाथ विद द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ श्रीला प्रभुपाद ऑल आर गुरु परंपरा आ शिक्षा गुरुज And with the blessings of all the assembled Vaishnavas, let us glorify Shri Krishna from Srimad Bhagavatam and hear from Srimad Bhagavatam. So we are reading Canto 3, Chapter 5, text number 21, today. Vidura's talks with Maitreya Muni. Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam.
Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam.
Sammatah Sanugasyah.
Sammatah Sanugasyah.
Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan.
Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan.
Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam. Sammatah Sanugasyah. Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan. Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam. Sammatha Sanugasyah. Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan. Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam. Sammata Sanugasyaha. Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan. Vaishnavis. Okay, yeah. Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam. Sammatah Sanugasyah. Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan. Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam. Sammatah Sanugasyah. Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan. Bhavan Bhagavato Nityam. Sammatah Sanugasyah. Yasya Jnanopadeshaya. Madishad Bhagavan Vrajan. Let us see the word to word meaning. Bhavan, your good self. Bhagavataha, of the personality of Godhead. Nityam, eternal. Sammataha, recognized. Sa Anugasya, one of the associates. Ha, have been. Yasya, of whom. Jnana, knowledge. Upadeshaya, for instructing. Ma, unto me. Adishat, so ordered. Bhagavan, the personality of Godhead. Vrajan, while returning to his abode. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Your good self is one of the eternal associates of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, for whose sake the Lord, while going back to his abode, left instructions with me. Purport. Yamaraja, the great controller of life after death, decides the living entities' destinies in their next lives. He is surely among the most confidential representatives of the Lord. Such confidential posts are offered to great devotees of the Lord who are as good as His eternal associates in the spiritual sky. And because Vidura happened to be among them, the Lord, while returning to Vaikuntha, left instructions for Vidura with Maitreya Muni. Generally, the eternal associates of the Lord in the spiritual sky do not come to the material world. Sometimes they come, however, by the order of the Lord, not to hold any administrative post, but to associate with the Lord in person or to propagate the message of God in human society. Such empowered representatives are called Shaktyavesha Avataras, or incarnations invested with transcendental power of attorney. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Let us do Mangalacharan. Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Ena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bishtam Stapitam Ena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Gurum Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakan Vidamsha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Bhutair Mahadbhi Yayima Puro Vibhu Nirmayashete Yadamosha Purusha Bhungtair Gunamsho Dashashoda Satmaka Solankrashishta Bhagavan Vachamsime Shri Krishna Sharanam Sharanagatam Katha Amritam Satatapibatam Bhakti Vedanta Marka Panktanam Sarvalokarishi Deva Janna Prasannam Sarvalokarishi Deva Janna Prasannam Hare Krishna. So welcome again to today's Srimad Bhagavatam. So this is such a beautiful verse where Maitreya Muni is speaking to Vidura. All the verses in Srimad Bhagavatam are so beautiful. So it is said that wherever we take a little bite from Srimad Bhagavatam, it's like a sugar candy. It tastes so sweet. And here there are many beautiful points that are given and many beautiful words. Bhagavato nityam sammataha sa anugasyaha. Just that line itself is very, very deep. That is the eternal associates of the Supreme Lord. And to follow in their footsteps. So, just that one line if we take, there is so much that we can meditate on. And there is, you know, we can just go on speaking about it and hearing about it. And today, given that here in the context of this verse, Maitreya Muni is speaking about Yamaraja, who is a close associate of the Supreme Lord. And how, due to a curse from Mandavya Muni, Yamaraj has descended in the form of Vidura. So what we have been hearing in the previous verses in this chapter is that Vidura is humbly speaking to Maitreya Muni and he is asking for instructions about how to lead one's life in this material world. And then he goes on to ask about, please explain to me about the incarnations of the Supreme Lord, about his divine activities. And please kindly instruct me on all these transcendental topics. So then Maitreya Muni, now he begins to speak from the just a few verses before, from the 18th verse. So first he glorifies Vidura. So just a few days before, we were hearing in one of, I think, His Grace Bhava Vibhushan Prabhuji's lecture, he was saying how when devotees speak to each other, they glorify each other first. So Vidura is glorifying Maitreya Muni. He's saying how great you are and then kindly instruct me with humility. And then Maitreya Muni, when he is speaking to Vidura, he is again addressing him with a humble mood. He doesn't just feel, oh, I'm great and I'm speaking to you and I'm giving you the instructions. But he is in turn glorifying Vidura. So in these verses, the first few verses, before he even begins to speak about the Lord, he's first glorifying Vidura. He's giving us a background about who is Vidura, what a great personality he is. He's not an ordinary person. So then he says that due to a curse from Mandavya Muni, Yamaraj. Now who is Yamaraj? He is the Lord of Death. He is one of the 12 Mahajanas. So it is said that the 12 Mahajanas are very great personalities who know the real essence of the Supreme Lord, that is devotion to Him. They know the real essence of all our religious principles. And that is why they are called as the Mahajanas. So we hear about that in the Canto 6 of Srimad Bhagavatam, where Yamaraj is speaking to his attendants or his assistants, the Yamadutas. So there, we know that in the Ajamila pastime, what happened? The Yamadutas, they went to grab Ajamila because he was such a, you know, he had gone into such a degraded life. But nevertheless, just at the time of his death, just by calling out to his little son, Narayana, just by that one word, what happened? All the Vishnudutas immediately arrived there. And then they wanted to save Ajamila. So then the Yamadutas got bewildered. They were wondering, what is this? I mean, we thought our Lord Yamaraja is the greatest and whatever order he gives, we have to follow. And now we have come to take Ajamila. And who are all these beautiful personalities who are standing in front of me? The Vishnu Dutas. Who are all they? What is all this? So then the Yamadutas, they go and they ask Yamaraja. They are asking him, please, you know, kindly clarify this situation. We thought you are our Supreme Lord. Then Yamaraja, he goes on to speak about the Supreme Lord. And he says that he is the Supreme Controller and we are all just assisting him. He has just given us the strength to carry out his orders. That is all. And that is what all of us are as well. So none of us are, you know, really the great leaders or great speakers or great personalities. We have just been blessed by Radha Gopinath through his mercy to carry out his order, coming through our Guru Parampara. So there Yamaraja, he explains and he says in this beautiful verse, Swayambhur Narada Shambhu Kumara Kapilo Manuhu Pralado Janako Bhishmo Balir Vayasakir Vayam Dvadashaite Vijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bata Guhyam Vishuddham Durbodham Yam Nyatvamritam Ashnute. So here Yamaraja is speaking about the 12 Mahajanas. Who are those 12 great personalities? He starts with Swayambhu, who is Lord Brahma. Then Narad Muni. And then Shambhu. Who is Shambhu? Lord Shiva. And then Kumaraha, the four Kumaras. Then Kapilo, that is Kapila Muni. And then Manuhu, which is the first Manu, that is Swayambhuva Manu. Then Prahlado, we know Prahlad, the son of Hiranyakashipu, but the greatest devotee of the Supreme Lord. And then Janako, we know Janaka. And then that is Mother Sita's father. And then Bhishmo, Bhishma Dev. Balir, that is King Bali, Maharaj Bali, who was blessed by Vaman Dev. And then Vayasakir, so that is another name for Shukadev Goswami. And then Vayam, so that refers to Yamaraja himself. So here itself we can see the humility of Yamaraj. He is putting himself at the end. He's not starting off by saying Vayam Swambhur Narada Shambhu. You know, he's speaking about all the great devotees and at the end he's saying, you know, this person also who is me. We are all, we have been, we know the religious principles. And then he's saying that this is not easily understood by everyone. And therefore, by the instruction of the Supreme Lord, we are passing it on to everyone. So I thought we will reflect a little bit on Yamaraj today. You know, not very often we hear about Yamaraj. Why? Because people are scared. He's the Lord of Death. Everyone thinks that if we think of Yamaraj, he will come and get me. But who is Yamaraj? As we have been seeing, he is the one of the 12 Mahajanas, a great devotee of the Lord. And as devotees, for us even, we see death as Krishna. Because then it gives us an opportunity to go back to him. If we have lived a righteous life, if we have lived a life of serving Sri Krishna. So Yamaraj is also known as Kala or time and Dharmaraja or the Lord of Dharma or truth. He is the Lord of truth. So he doesn't see any, he has no favoritism for anyone. If someone has done something wrong, That's it. He has to punish them. If somebody has done something right, then he awards them a beautiful life in their next life. Or then he decides whether he has really lived such a pure life, then he sends him to Krishna. So Yamaraja is a very special person, and we have to also take blessings from him, so that at the end of our life, you know, we can please Yamaraj, and he knows, okay, this devotee, all right, you know, some mistakes she or he may have done, but then, you know, this devotee really loves Krishna. So I want to see that. And then, but if we have done that truthfully from our heart, then Yamaraj can send us back to Krishna. And Yamaraj is called as Lokapala. That is, he is one of the custodians of the one of the directions. So we have the eight directions, isn't it? North, south, east, west, and all the northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest, and the center. So each of these directions have a presiding deity. So for the center, the presiding deity is Lord Brahma. For the eastern direction, it is Lord Indra. Then for southeast, it is Agni. And the Lord of the south is Yamaraj. And then for southwest, it is Niruti. Then the Lord of the west is Varuna. Then for northwest, it is Vayu. And then for the north, it is Lord Kubera. And then northeast is Ishanya, who is also a form of Lord Shiva. So the Lord of South is Yamaraj. Now there is a beautiful song which we perform in, you know, in one of our dance repertoire, in the Bharatanatyam repertoire. We perform a piece from the Navasandhi Kautuvam. That is, these are pieces in praise of the lords of the eight directions. And there is one that glorifies Yamaraj so beautifully. So it says that, I will sing a little bit and then we'll meditate on that. For the pleasure of Sri Radha Gopinath, glorifying Yamaraj.
Dakshinapatiyum Sandhikaladutadisainya Dandayudan Daksha Mahishārohana Shyamala Devi Sahita Arpatan Paksha Dharma Guna Sarvam Vasham Marakarta Simhasanan Mechulalita Vadanditam Ditaka Sarigama Padasa Desakshi Dandapadanatam Suchipashamam Bringitalam Tadhim Ditam Tadintaka Andinor Karulum Kaushika Panna Yamadishaika Utvame.
So this beautiful piece, it says that Lord Yama, he's a Dakshinapati, so Lord of the southern direction. And he is colored like the night. So he is Sandhikala, you know, like the dusk or the, you know, the, when the sun is setting. So he's colored like that. And Shyamala Devi is his consort or his wife, his goddess. And then Yamaraj, he is the, he doesn't see any parapaksham. Parapaksha is a word that means, you know, like I said, he has no favoritism. So whatever is the truth, he abides by that and he punishes people. And he's got these weapons of a mace and a pasha or the noose. So with these two weapons, he is taking the lives of people, you know, at the time of death. So he uses these weapons, the mace and the noose. So like this, you know, there is so much that we can speak about Yamaraj. But let us go on to what else is said in this verse, just, you know, given the time that we have to, you know, meditate on so much. So, Yamaraj, again, he says, let us meditate on the instructions that he has given. So we saw about his personality, who he is, who is Lord Yamaraj. And now let us see the one of the instructions that he has given his Yamadutas. So he says, he instructs his assistants to bring four types of persons. He says, you know, at the time of death, bring me these four types of people. Now, who are they?
Jihvanavakti Bhagavad Guna Namadeyam Chetaschana Smaratita Charanaravindam Krishna Vanonamatiya Chira Ekadapi Tan Anavyadhyam Asato Krita Vishnu Krityan.
So he says, my dear servants, he's speaking to the Yamadutas, and he says, please bring to me only those sinful persons who do not use their tongue, jighvana bhakti, who do not use their tongues to chant the holy names and the qualities of Krishna. So whoever doesn't chant his holy names, they better be careful, because Yamaraj is waiting to get them. The Yamadutas are waiting to get them. So on the contrary, what is the opposite that we do? By following the instructions of our gurus, we chant the holy names of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So even once if we have chanted, this goes into our record. So Yamadutas have seen, oh, all these people who are sitting in the temple, they've chanted Hare Krishna, you know, I won't take them. So from this we learn how important it is to chant the names and the glories of Krishna. It is not a joke. We have to take it really seriously. And that is why we are singing. So we are not singing to, you know, show off our skills or talents. But when we have some talent or skill, then we engage it in the service of Krishna to glorify Him for His pleasure and for the pleasure of the devotees. So with that mood, when we approach any seva, then Krishna is pleased with us. And then the Yamadutas cannot touch us. Then Yamaraj says, bring those persons whose hearts do not remember the lotus feet of Krishna. So whoever doesn't remember the lotus feet of Krishna, so they go into the record of the Yamadutas. So what do we have to do? Constantly remember Krishna. So the opposite of that, and which was given to us in a beautiful instruction by Prahlad Maharaj, by following the Navavida Bhakti, we can constantly remember Sri Krishna. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasevanam Archanam Vandanam Dhasyam Sakhyam Atmanivedhanam. So any one of these processes, if we can try and follow and perfect it, then just by that we are constantly remembering Krishna. So, you know, just by hearing about Krishna, so someone may not be able to sing, or someone may not be able to, you know, remember Krishna. Someone may not be able to serve Krishna, you know, by touching his feet. The pujaris are all so, you know, blessed. They are constantly touching Radha Gopinath. Now, some of us who still can't do that, just by hearing, you know, just hearing, that is easy to do, isn't it? Just by hearing, we can remember the lotus feet of Krishna. So like that, by following these nine processes, we can always hold Krishna's lotus feet in our heart. And then Yamaraj says, bring those whose heads do not bow down even once before Lord Krishna. So, if they have not bowed down to Krishna even once, then they go into the record of the Yamadutas. So, at least all of us here, I think we are saved in that respect, because the minute we come into the temple, we bow down to Radha Gopinath, we bow down to Srila Prabhupada. So, from this we can see that we have to always bow down to Sri Krishna. So, in fact, in one of his lectures, His Holiness Bhaktirasamrita Swami Maharaj, he was explaining that, you know, bowing down before Krishna is not just the act of bowing down, you know, physically, just placing your head down there and your, you know, the sashtanga, not just that. But bowing down comes from the heart. It is that humility. To tell Krishna, when we bow down, I am your servant. Please accept me as your servant. So we recited in the Sikshashtakam today, Stitta Dhuli Sadrishyam Vichintaya. Please place me as a little, you know, tiny particle of dust at your lotus feet. So we have to try and imbibe these sublime qualities. They are easily spoken than done. But somehow we have to take them to our heart. And at least when we bow down, we can say, Krishna, please accept me as your servant. And then Yamaraj says, send me those who do not perform their duties toward Vishnu. So, the duties toward Vishnu. Now, that is a very big word. So, there, Srila Prabhupada in the purport, he very beautifully explains what is Vishnu Kirtayan. So, that is the duties toward Lord Vishnu. He says that the Varnashram Dharma has been given so that in the human society, we can perform our duties according to our varna and our ashrama. So that is why this whole system is given there. We have the brahmachari, grahastra, vanaprastha and sannyas ashrams, you know, different ashrams of life. So no matter wherever we are, according to that ashram, we have to fulfill our duties to the fullest extent that we can, with the mercy of our Guru and Sri Krishna. So just by fulfilling those duties, again, we are pleasing Krishna. And then again, we are not in the record of the Yamadutas, because we are fulfilling our duties. So the husband and wife in the grahasthashram, they perform duties towards each other. So that itself is pleasing to Krishna. And then the brahmacharis, you know, so they perform their duties. And then the vanaprasthas, you know, in their retired life. So they go on pilgrimage. They go to different sthalas and they try to serve devotees. And then in the sannyas ashram, which is the renounced order, which is at the, you know, very high platform. But still we can be renounced in our heart, no matter wherever, in whichever level we are at, we can be renounced in our heart so that we can always be connected to serving Krishna.
So here, Vishnu Kirtayan is a very important point. One is performing the duties of life. And then if we see the other meaning, Vishnu Kirtayan, singing the Kirti of Vishnu. And who did that most beautifully? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who taught us how to glorify and attain pure love for Krishna. So in this beautiful, the purport, Srila Prabhupada explains about the Sakshaktya Vesha avatars. So he says that there are different types of avatars of the Supreme Lord. Yeah, so we will try to meditate a little bit on that, and let us try to see what we can understand about the Shaktya Vesha avataras. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in his instructions to Sanatan Goswami, he explains about the various different types of avataras of the Supreme Lord. Now they are all just innumerable. We cannot even count them. But at the same time, he classifies them into different divisions and he speaks a little about each of them. So he begins with the Purushavataras, who are the three Vishnu forms. The Karanodakashayi Vishnu, who is lying on the causal ocean, from whose pores, when he exhales, innumerable universes are generated. And then the Garbhodakashayi Vishnu, the form of Vishnu who enters each universe and he is maintaining that particular universe. And then the Kshirodakashayi Vishnu, who resides in the heart of every living entity in each of those universes as the Paramatma. So Vishnu is residing in each of our hearts. And that's why we have to be very careful in our dealings with each other as devotees, as human beings, even to the animals, because Lord Krishna is in the heart of that little ant, of that little tree, of the little flower, in the heart of the butterfly. So we have to be very compassionate towards everyone. So these are the three Purushavataras. Then we have the Leelavataras, that is the Supreme Lord. He takes different incarnations to perform his various Leelas or his pastimes. So we have the Matsya Avatara, the Kurma Avatara, Varaha, Lord Narasimhadev. You know, he is a Leelavatar of the Supreme Lord. Then all the 10 the Dashavatars. So they are all different Leelavatars of Krishna and even many more. So these are just a few examples. And then we have the Gunavataras of the Lord. And who is that? That is Lord Brahma, Lord Vishnu and Lord Shiva. So Lord Brahma, who is the creator, he is in charge of the mode of passion. Because you need some passion to create something, you know, because if someone is very calm and quiet and, you know, then something cannot be done. So Lord Brahma was empowered and he's the Lord of the mode of passion. And then we have Lord Vishnu, who is the presiding Lord of the mode of goodness. So the guna of sattva gun. That is Lord Vishnu, and he is maintaining. And then Lord Shiva, who is considered as Lord Krishna himself, but who touches the material world for the purpose of destruction. And therefore, he is the Lord of ignorance, the mode of nature of ignorance, or the tamogun, because that is needed for destruction. So these are the Gunavatars of the Supreme Lord. And then we have the Manvantra Avataras. That is, for each Manu, there is a different incarnation. So this is again innumerable. So it is explained that there are 14 manus in one kalpa or one day of Lord Brahma. And for each manu, there is a manmantra avatara. So now this each day of Lord Brahma is, I couldn't even actually count it properly, but I'll try saying it. Please correct me if I make a mistake. I think it is 4.32 million earth years. Is that right? Billion. Okay, because what I can see is 4, 3, 2, and then there are 8 zeros after that. I couldn't get the exact number by heart. So 4.32 billion earth years. That is one day of Brahma. And in that one day, there are 14 manus. So we can imagine how many manus there are. So how many manvantara avataras there are of the Supreme Lord. And this Swayambhuva Manu is the first Manu. So he is again the one of the Mahajanas, as we saw. And then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he explains about the Yuga avataras. So the Yuga avataras are the incarnations of the Lord for each Yuga. So for example, in Treta Yuga, he incarnated as Lord Ram. And then in Dwapar Yuga, he came himself as Lord Krishna, as a little darling child of Vrindavana, the blackish blue boy. And then in Kali Yuga, he attains the golden yellow complexion and he is the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So they are all the Yuga avataras. And then he speaks about the Shaktyavesha avataras. So the Shaktyavesha avataras, they are empowered personalities. So when Lord Krishna himself comes down, then he is Sakshat. He is himself. And Avesha is when he empowers someone else to represent him, his energies. So that is why it is said that there are innumerable personalities who are Shaktyavesha avataras. So we can see how Yamaraj, who was empowered by the Supreme Lord, and then he again in his next, when he was cursed and then when he was born, he appeared as Vidura. So Srila Prabhupada explains in the purport that we were reading today that the personalities, the eternal associates of the Supreme Lord who are always with him, they all always do not come down to the material creation. But by the order of Sri Krishna, they come down to the material world and they are empowered to perform certain activities. So for example, when Lord Krishna took birth on the, or when he appeared, not took birth, it's not the right word. So when he appeared in this material universe, he instructed all the wives of the demigods to appear. So that by associating with the Supreme Lord in the material universe, they will then again, they can go back to the spiritual world. So whenever the Lord descends, his eternal associates, by the order of the Lord, they descend. Why? Is it simply to just have fun? No. They are descending to give pleasure to Krishna. They are again descending to be engaged in the pastimes of Sri Krishna and to carry out his instructions. So that is why when we see when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Lord Krishna himself, when he took the form of the devotee, then the eternal associates of the Supreme Lord also descended with him. So we see that, you know,
पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकम्।
सो लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु हु टुक द फॉर्म ऑफ द डिवोटी टू रिलिश द लव फॉर श्री कृष्णा एंड देन व्हाट हैपेंड His elder brother, Krishna's elder brother, Lord Balram, appeared as Nityananda Prabhu. And then Lord Krishna's expansion, or the Mahavishnu, so he appeared as Advaita Acharya. And then it is said that in Vrajalila, Srimati Radharani, who was the dearmost beloved of Shri Krishna, and we see a manifestation of her in the Gadadhar Pandit, one of the Panchatattvas. And then Srivas Thakur, he is said to be a manifestation of Narad Muni. So the five of them, they again in the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela, they gave pleasure to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through all his pastimes. Constantly they were interacting in so many different ways. So I was just reading a very beautiful line. Just as how Srimati Radharani would make a beautiful garland of flowers and place it on the neck of Shri Krishna, like that Gadadhar Pandit, he also makes a beautiful garland of flowers and he places it on the neck of Shri Krishna. And then he makes nice chandan pulp to apply it on the body of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So when Srimati Radharani wanted to place the garland on Shri Krishna's neck, we see that in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela, Gadadhar Pandit, he is taking that mood. So like that, the Shaktyavesha avatars, now our spiritual masters, now they are all very empowered personalities. So they have come into this universe just to teach us and to take us back to Krishna. So they are all also considered and respected as Shaktyavesha avataras of the Supreme Lord, because they have that power. Not any person can just deliver the fallen souls on this world unless they are empowered by Shri Krishna. So there is so much to discuss and share. Just with the time, we will try to end here, but we will finish with a beautiful verse. So let us try to meditate on one of the instructions of Yamaraj, which is Vishnu Kirtayan, glorifying Lord Vishnu. And there is a beautiful verse which the four Kumaras, again one of the Mahajanas we saw, so how they are they are saying that whenever we hear about Shri Krishna and his qualities and his pastimes and his glories, it is like an ornament for our ear. So these ornaments that we wear, you know, the golden earrings, diamond earrings, nice jhumkis, they can all decorate this physical body. But the real ornament for our ears, you know, for our soul, that is hearing about the glories and the pastimes of Shri Krishna.
हरेर मुहुस्तत परकर्ण पूर गुणाभिदानेन विजृंभमानया भक्त्या ह्य संघ सदस्यत्यनात्मनि स्यान्निर्गुणे ब्रह्मणि चांजसारतिहि।
So in the translation, Srila Prabhupada says, the devotee should gradually increase the culture of devotional service by constant hearing of the transcendental qualities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. These pastimes are like ornamental decorations on the ears of the devotees. By rendering devotional service and transcending the material qualities, one can easily be fixed in transcendence, in the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And this is what was exemplified by Vidura. So Vidura exemplified this beautiful quality of decorating his ears by wanting to hear Krishna Katha from Maitreya Muni. So on that note, we will end today's class and let us chant Hare Krishna for the pleasure of Shishi Radha Gopinath. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki jai.